Talk ain't gonna get it either. When you come to a stop, you supposed to signal.
Oh.
Ain't no sense of you acting all loud and black and savage.
Hey, man, I'm gonna have to call a cop for you, man. I can see that, Jack.
When you call the National Guard, you still got the signal when you stop.
Oh, man, you got to be crazy.
Oh, man, call the Army, call the Navy, call your mama, baby. Can I get a witness? Anybody want to be a witness? See this fool stop over there and didn't even make a signal? Hey, mama, do y'all want to be a witness?
Can you imagine a cat doing that to a brother?
Oh, man.
Your coffee, Mr. Brooks.
Yeah. Yes, yes. Brilliant. Brilliant.
Booker T gave me the idea last night. And the only thing wrong with it is that I didn't think of it myself. This'll fix his wagon.
A son of mine living on the roof.
You've got to know how to handle these college boys, Mrs. Brooks. Oh, Dad, blast it. There. You can give this to your youngest son. And tell him that my demands are non-negotiable.
Yes, Mr. Brooks.
Your appointment book, please, Mrs. Brooks. You have some free time around noon. I think you should take a walk. Yes, walk. There. You have a good schedule today, Mrs. Brooks.
Thank you, Mr. Brooks.
It seems the Plessy Company has made a $658 million tender offer to Zanzibar Steel Company.
Brilliant move.
Oh, Mrs. Brooks, you'll have to wear your blue dress to Gail's wedding.
But you promised me a new one.
I know, Mrs. Brooks, but it's a simple matter of economics. Gail's wedding is costing me more than I anticipated.
But I haven't had a new dress since you retired from the Army.
I know, Mrs. Brooks, but the entire economic situation is shaky at this time.
Yes, Mr. Brooks.
There, Mrs. Brooks. Although Gail knew I had my heart set on her going to college, I'm not mad anymore.
Thank you, Mr. Brooks.
What's Gail getting up so early for? Why Gideon can't be more like his brother Booker T, I'll never know. Oh, if I could get just one hand on that youngest son of yours, Mrs. Brooks. Always talking about the white power structure this and the white power structure that. I'll show him something about black power structure.
I wish you two could try to get along, Mr. Brooks.
You know I've tried, Mrs. Brooks. But what can you do when that rebel on the roof is stubborn, pig-headed, and ungrateful? But you can still be proud of yourself, Mrs. Brooks. Why, just look how sensible our oldest son, Booker T, has turned out to be. And you know how we used to fight all the time. But he's working steady now in that poverty program, trying to get ahead.
Gail! Oh, she'll be mad if I don't wake her up. Gail! Gail! Gail, wake up now. It's late.
All right, Mama.
Turn down that dead blasted radio. Booker T stayed over last night. He's trying to get some sleep. That's one noisy girl. Well, in 2 days, she'll be Martin's problem.
Marvin. His name is Marvin, Mr. Brooks.
Him and his African wedding? He's almost as crazy as his good friend Gideon, insisting on a mumbo-jumbo wedding.
Daddy! For the millionth time, it is not a mumbo-jumbo wedding.
Why must you have an African wedding? Your mother and I raised you as a good Christian.
Daddy, this is the 20th century. It's our way of saying we're black people.
Huh. So that's what it's all about. My dear girl, black people have always been black ever since I can remember. And they didn't have to take on a lot of foreign ways either.
Foreign ways? Gail! Gail!
See? See? Every time I try to get an understanding around here, some child of mine goes storming off.
Gail, come back here and apologize to your father.
All I did was ask her a civil question, Mrs. Brooks.
I'm sorry, Daddy. I know I shouldn't explode like that. It's just that... Well, I just wish that you and Gideon would stop fighting before my wedding, okay?
You little rascal, you.
Remember when I was 11 and almost pushed the panic button because I didn't have a boyfriend? Oh, wow. I just knew I'd be an old maid. And now I have Marvin. Mama, sometimes I'm so happy it's frightening.
Oh, Gideon.
Oh, Mama.
Gideon, you don't know how happy I am for you. You don't know how I prayed for this day to come. Because when you get married, I can keep a promise I made to myself many years ago. You see, I promised myself...
I'll get it. Hello? Oh, Marvin.
Everybody, just relax. Have no fear. The kid is here.
You need a bath.
Come on, now's that any way to talk about your baby boy, your pride and joy, huh, Mama?
I said a bath.
Come on now, sweet cakes.
And right now, come in my kitchen smelling like a Cheshire cat.
Mama!
And use some soap this time.
Well, you're getting about bad as Daddy.
Catherine and Nia called up this morning. They're on their way over, and
alarm clocks, radios, telephone.
We're gonna all meet, and we're gonna go to the hall and we're gonna decorate.
Yeah. Getting in there sounded like something crawled up his throat and died. Man, getting on the pad was a hip move. A very hip move.
Good morning, son. You want some breakfast?
No, Ma. Just some coffee.
Bye, love.
See you later. Hey, Booker T.
Hey, girl. Don't be calling me by that slave name. And you know everybody calls me Cherie.
Sorry about that. I forgot. That was Marvin. Oh, Mama. We're gonna be so happy.
Oh, Mama. We're gonna be so happy. Girl, when you gonna come out of that Doris Day bag, walking around in that jive dress?
I just wish Daddy wasn't so quick to judge people. I mean, I'm sure he'd like Marvin if he got to know him.
Girl, you know Dad ain't never gonna dig no jailbird.
Refusing to fight in the war ain't no crime. At least Marvin stood up for his convictions. You know, sometimes I don't understand you, Booker T. Excuse me, I mean, Sharif. I mean, I'm tired of your criticism. I want to see some of your activism.
You beginning to sound like that creep Gideon.
Booker T, Gideon is your baby brother.
Oh, Mama, Gideon is stone incorrect. Confusing people, talking that talk. Now, the real solution to the black man's problem is so simple. Hey, come on, Gail. Now, dig this. You know I'm right. Now, Chairman Mao's already given the word. Power comes from the barrel of the gun. We all know that the white man ain't nothing but the devil. And everything we do should be geared towards his destruction.
Hmm. I got better things to do than be sitting around murder-mouthing people.
Hey,
Gail.
You.
Booker T. Now, you can listen to this, too, if you want to. I was just telling your sister about a promise that I made to myself a long time ago. I promised myself that when Gail got married, I was going to...
Go ahead, sis.
Yeah. Oh, Marvin sure is one lucky dude.
Hey, Mama. Mama, we should be living in Africa. But Marvin would have to give the family at least, 500 cattle. He might even have to throw in about 1,000 head of sheep. Might even have to throw in some live lions, Booker T.
Hey, man, you know my name.
Man, I'm sorry, I forgot. I'll remember next time, Booker T.
Yeah, well, you better dig yourself, man.
Gideon, I wish you two wouldn't be at each other so much. A body wouldn't know you were brothers.
Booker T. Washington Brooks. Oh, the old man sure did lay a name on you, didn't he?
Man, you do better going on the line, huh, with a toothpick than messing with me this morning.
Boy, you better practice a little bit of that revolutionary discipline there, yeah?
I done told you to dig yourself. Now I'm buying all the wolf tickets you selling this morning,
now,
man.
Now, look, we raised you two to love and respect one another.
Hey, man, I'd like to talk to you about something.
About what?
It's in private.
Yeah, well, I've been laying to talk to you about something in private, too. I'll meet you when I come back from helping Gail, yeah?
That's cool. I'll meet you on the roof?
Yeah, okay.
There. Now, well, Gideon, before you came in, I was telling Gail and Booker T how happy I am that she's getting married, because when she gets married...
Well, that must be the truth, Mama.
Hey!
Man, I didn't think you were going to show.
You know I was.
Right?
Hey. I was broke.
Hey, Gail. Let me lay this new step on you. Hey. Learning from some brothers across town.
That's it. That's what? What is it?
The black egg sign.
Oh, baby.
I
think
the
egg
sign. Why don't you introduce your brother to Catherine?
Yeah, Sharif. I want you to meet a S-I-S-T-E-R. Catherine, this is my brother, Sharif.
Nice to meet you. Want to dance?
Yeah. I've heard a lot about you.
Oh, yeah? Is that good or bad?
Doesn't matter. See, I make up my own mind. Oh, hey, let's break it up. I gotta meet Marvin and do some shopping, and I'll meet you guys later at the hall. Okay.
Hey, wait, Gail, let me walk you this part of the
way. Yeah, many walk a part of the way.
Gideon, can I talk to you for a minute?
Yo, go ahead. I'll be there in a minute.
Okay, I'll hold the elevator for you.
Yeah, Mama.
Mr. Brooks left this for you.
Okay.
Gideon, your father was up at 5 o'clock this morning writing it, and you could at least read it. Go on.
dear son, Gideon. Since time is making its noble presence felt upon me, I shall be brief and not remind you of how I, as a poor and hungry black youth, stood for hours in the bread lines during the Depression. But you know that. And that is why I can't understand how you can be on strike against your own father because he wants you to be a business major. You know full well that a degree in anthropology does not prepare one to earn money. Oh, wow, Mama. It is you who is involved in those political activities at your school and thereby jeopardizing your entire college career. And finally, it is you who refuses to speak to your loving father. Therefore, my demands are that you cool it, that all of these transgressions be rectified immediately, if not sooner. I realize how difficult it must be for you, in fact, for all of my children, to follow in such large, illustrious footsteps as mine. Gideon, you disappoint me. If you were Jewish, I'd have shiva set on you. However, I shall be kind, forgiving, and loving as soon as you meet my demands. Your loving father, Mr. Brooks. He's full of stuff.
Gideon.
Well, he is, Mama. Talking about somebody following in his illustrious footsteps. You'd think he was running General Motors instead of that little old barber shop.
Being a barber is honest work.
Yeah, I know, Mama. I wouldn't sound on Dad because he's a barber. It's just that I know where he's coming from. Mama, a college education is not something that you get just so as you can get a better job. No, an education is a tool, Mama. It's a tool you use to help your people.
Hey, man, you coming?
Yeah, I'm coming, man. I'm coming. See, Mama, Dad wants me to play it safe. He wants me to join the system. If I did that, Mama, I'd be turning my back on everything that I believe in.
I guess you're right. We always taught you to stand up for what you believe in. Gideon.
Yeah, Mama.
Hey, Gideon, come on, man, it's time to go.
It'd be cool, man. Yeah, Mom.
Nothing. Go on, they're waiting for you. What I have to say can wait for another time.
Yeah, okay. Huh? I'll see you later.
Bye, son.
Hey, sweet me, how'd you like to buy some sirloin steaks today?
Nah, come back tomorrow, man.
Tomorrow? Oh, man, you must be out your damn mind.
Morning, Mr. Brooks.
Morning, Preston.
Hey, schoolboy.
I got your schoolboy, sweet me.
When's that class finished, Preston?
2 more months.
Then you'll be gone, huh?
Like a turkey through the corn.
My man, Preston, hard into himself.
Some real estate.
Ow!
That's right. People without land's in serious trouble. Whole thing's about land.
You look like a sheep.
Now, John Henry, don't start that stuff today.
Now, you know how I feel about that in my shop.
I'm not a customer.
And besides, he goes to college.
How's Preston?
Hi, Preston.
Hi, Greg, Gillette, Jean Natche, AJ.
Hello there, Wild Ruth.
Y'all kids move over and let Miss Brooks have. Okay, let me see. Okay, there you go. Now get it!
Y'all be careful on them swings! I don't want nobody coming in here crying this morning!
Oh, don't use that one, Gladys. It's broke.
Oh, thanks, Ruby. That would be all I'd need this morning.
What's the matter, Gladys?
If you catch a sucker, bump his head. That's what they say? The trouble is, they're talking about me.
Oh, girl.
No, it's true, Ruby, and you know it. I just let everybody push me around.
Oh, come on, Gladys. What's Mr. Brooks done now?
Oh, the way that man courted me before we got married. Sugar sweet names, he called me. And the day after we got married, he started calling me Mrs. Brooks. And now he's got me keeping that old appointment book so he'll know what I'm doing every minute of the day. One of these days, I'm gonna throw that old appointment book out the window. That's what I'm gonna do. The only thing I don't have to put in it is when I cough or go to the bathroom.
Ah, child.
And don't let me even look like I'm gonna disagree with him. Then he rants and raves up a storm, acts like he's gone thunder and lightning for 40 days and 40 nights.
If there ever was a man who knows how to get mad, it's Mr. Brooks.
Last week, I overspent on buying groceries. Talk about a man carrying on. You would have thought that 17 cent was gonna cause a panic down on Wall Street.
I'm on your side, girl. But I will say this for Mr. Brooks. He does have good intentions.
My granny always said the road to hell is paved with good intentions.
My granny always used to say there's some good in everybody.
Well, if there is some good in Mr. Brooks, he done a Houdini with it and made it disappear, because you sure can't see it.
All in all, child, I don't know.
And don't let me even think about asking him to take me somewhere. Then he tells me about his mother, what a good woman she was, and how easy we modern women have, and how she worked from sun up to sundown. To hear him talk about that woman, you'd think she was Joan of Arc, Virgin Mary, and Aretha Franklin all rolled into one.
Gladys, don't be so hard on
yourself. No, 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 Ruby, I made up my mind this morning. I'm keeping a long-time promise. I am leaving Mr. Brooks.
Now, girl, you know ain't it all that easy.
Telling me that I can't buy a new dress for my own daughter's wedding? Well, if there's such a thing as a last straw, that was it.
Now, Gladys, we all know Mr. Brooks has his problems, but that don't mean you gotta leave him. After all, there is such a thing as jumping from the refrigerator into the frying pan.
Oh, now, Ruby, be serious.
I am just as serious as cancer. At least he is dependable.
Hmm.
He ain't never been known to mess up with a piece of money.
Well, a lot of good that does me. Everything in the house is in his name. My name don't appear on nothing except the income tax deduction form.
But you still got a nip.
No, Ruby, I made up my mind this morning. I'm leaving.
Deep in the heart of the kingdom of Styx, the animals had a pool room. But the baboon slick. Till up jumped the monkey from Coconut Grove. He said, let me get some of this money for this place closed. The baboon said, man, you want to shoot some pool? Monkey said, I can't shoot no pool. But if you pull up a stump to fit your rump, I'll play you some coon can to your rear end jump.
Hey, John Henry. Gideon's still up on the roof?
I've asked you not to mention that name to me.
Boy, that Gideon is sure one out of sight, youngster.
You're entitled to your opinion.
Everyone is, I suppose. We'll just wait and see.
Hey, sweet meat.
Hmm?
I fixed his wagon this morning.
Really laid it on him, huh, John Henry? Thanks, home.
Put my foot down.
He's still on strike, ain't he?
He'll be a man soon. And then there'll just be me and Mrs. Brooks.
Still don't know how come you're so lucky to get a good woman like Mrs. Brooks.
What do you mean, luck? Mrs. Brooks is no accident. Why, I created her with these very hands.
Oh, talk that talk, John Henry.
Trouble with you, Preston, is that you don't understand women. Controlling women is an art. You have to have a certain knack.
Man, you're really on a trip. One of these days, Mrs. Brooks is gonna wake up and turn you completely around.
Preston, the possibility of Mrs. Brooks being able to, as you say, turn me completely around
is about as likely as you're going skiing in purgatory.
Don't be so mean, John Henry.
Can I help you, brother?
Yes. I'd like to speak to the barber who's in charge here.
You're looking at him.
Do you own this place, brother?
Lock, stock, and barrel.
Hey, right on. I'd like to put this in your window. It's for the legal defense of Brother Ollie Gamba.
This is the time, brothers. This is the time. The hunky dog is gonna have to pay. See, we must begin to unite on the basis of our color, because the pig power structure is daily becoming more fascist.
I'll see what we can do.
Fight on. Now, power to the people. Blood to the horse's brow, and woe to those that cannot swim, Jim.
Filthy mouth rascal. Calling people animals.
Oh, John Henry, where are you coming from? The brother was right. We got to stick together. Don't deal with how he said it. Deal with what the man said.
They're crazy. Going around talking about, say it loud, I'm black and I'm proud. I'll start listening when they change their tune.
Yeah.
Say it soft. I'm black. And I'm bald. Say it soft. I'm black and I'm bald. Ow. Hey, what's that?
Wow, you two belong in a museum. Your museum, Negroes. Talk about Uncle Tom's. You two are Uncle Remus's.
Say it soft, Preston. Say it soft. You know, sweet me, you are too much, baby.
You still should have given the brother a play, John Henry. And you're supposed to be a man of principles, too.
I am a man of principles, but sometimes you have to forget about principles and do what's right.
And as the rooster crowed, those who stood before the bar said, open the door, for we have so little time to stay, and once we're gone, we're not coming back this way. Mr. John Henry Brooks.
333.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, don't waste your time in the vain pursuit of this and that endeavor. Groove with the grape, for it is wiser to fly with the fruitful grape than it is to be high on hopes and illusions. Mr. Sweetmate.
505, and make that a three-way combination, please, sir.
Mr. Porterfat.
Ace, deuce, tray.
Make the most of the time that you have before you, too, are turned to dust. Dust to dust, dust to dust, and under dust to lie. Forever. Preston, oh, Preston. When I was young, I did eagerly visit philosophers and saints and heard great arguments about this and that. But every time I came out the same door I went in.
Give me 456, and I'll get my kicks.
We are nothing but a wandering row of shadows that come and go around a Halloween lantern held in the night by the masters of the show. Sir, 456, right?
Right on, baby.
Mr. Porterfat, ace, deuce, tray.
On time as you can.
Mr. John Henry Brooks, 333, right?
Right.
Sweep me, 505, and make that a three-way combination, please, sir.
Ah, shucks, right on.
And lately, through the open door, came shining through the dusk an angel bearing a huge vessel on her shoulder, and she offered me a taste from it. And I took it, too. Yes, I did. And it was the grape.
How a man can remember all those numbers without writing them down is a real deep, dark mystery to me.
It's simple enough, sweet meat. Rolls-Royce has what they call a photogenic memory.
A mind like that, and he's only a numbers runner. You know, Rolls ought to be down there somewhere on Wall Street.
What's wrong with you guys? You know as well as I do that Rolls-Royce has worked down on Wall Street for years. As an elevator operator.
I know it's not going to be easy to leave, but I just can't take it anymore. Everybody treats me like I'm an old couch.
Oh, Gladys.
Oh, Lord, I don't want anybody to catch me crying.
Well, well, just in time.
Oh, Stormy Monday. How you doing?
I'm doing it to death.
Well, look who's here. How you, Ruby?
Fine.
And how is Breck and Gillette and Jean Arte and Wildroot and Ajax?
Fine. Just fine. All the children is just fine.
I just came from your door, Gladys. Do you have any baking powder?
Sure. Come on.
Good.
Hey, Ruby.
I finished making your dress, but the way you keep gaining weight, I don't know if it still fits. Say, have you ever heard of the Weight Watchers?
You ever heard of S.I.J.?
No, it's S.I.J.
Sock in the jawless. It's good for people with diarrhea in the mouth. You mess with me this morning, girl, and I'm gonna give you a chance to try it.
Oh, really? Hey, Gladys, did you hear? The welfare people was by Ruby's house last night and almost caught Wilbur. Oh, now, talking about a man with heart hanging from the window 15 stories up. Ruby, you should have poured a lot on his ass.
Oh, Stormy, be nice. You shouldn't be so hard on men.
Yeah. Shoot. Now, after what you two been through, I don't see how you can even fix your mouth to say one good word about any man.
Now, Stormy, just because you've been burned a few times, you act like you got a patent on being evil.
Gladys, you're always saying that, and you know it's not true.
Yes, it is.
Well, the fact is, Gladys, you the one who's always complaining and crying and talking about you gonna leave Mr. Brooks. And you know you ain't going nowhere.
Yes, I am, too. I made up my mind this morning. I'm leaving.
Hey, Ruby, you think Gladys is going anywhere?
My name is Hess. I ain't in this mess. The only reason I stayed this long was because of the children. But it's different now. Gail is getting married and the boys are old enough to take care of themselves. When that preacher say, I now pronounce you man and wife, I'm starting me a new life.
Well, I'll say. Sit down. I'll bet you don't have any money saved, right, Ruby?
I told you I wasn't in this mess. I do, too, have money. I just haven't had a chance to save much. I got $27.31.
Oh, $27.31. Or where you planning on going, to the zoo?
Oh, come on,
oh,
Gladys.
Stormy.
Come on, I'm not trying to hurt you. I am just trying to make a point.
All right, now, after you get the money in straightened out, what is the next thing you do?
Oh, I don't know.
How about you, Ruby?
I don't know.
That ought to be easy for you, girl. Wilbur is always threatening to do it.
Pack his bags?
That's what I'm talking about. Now, have you started getting your clothes together yet?
Well, I was gonna take my walk first.
What kind of old walk? Truthfully, I don't think you are ready to leave Mr. Brooks.
No, Stormy Monday. I had you wrong for years, girl. You do have some sense after all.
Yeah, it was a lousy idea for you to leave Mr. Brooks. But you should do something. Let me think a minute. Say, I'm dry as a potato chip. Do you have anything to drink?
Down in the cabinet, Stormy. Speaking of potato chips, you got something else to nibble on, Gladys?
Ruby, there's cookies up in the cookie jar. Stormy, what did you say I ought to do?
This ought to do it.
Oh, how about you two young ladies? You want to join me?
Ruby,
I do not mind if I do have a little taste just for medicinal purposes.
That's my girl, Ruby.
Go right ahead. You know, Mr. Brooks don't like
to... See, do you see what I'm talking about?
Yeah, all right, but not too much. Not so much, Darmy.
Okay. Cheers.
Cheers. Now, what did you say I ought to do, Stormy?
Yeah, Stormy, quit stalling. Run down your commercial.
All right.
Well, the thing is, Gladys has got to change herself.
Change yourself?
Change myself.
That's right.
Wait, Gladys, sit. Let me run it down to you.
Good God! I sure hope I hit the day. I got to do me some mean chippy chasing. And for me to do that, I need some very heavy greens in my pocket.
Hey, sweet me.
Yeah.
You sure talk bad for a married man.
Hey, man.
My wife's the one that's married, not me. Having fun, loving?
What you want to happen, baby?
You got it.
Oh, yeah? Well, it's green lights all the way, baby. Nothing but green lights all the way. Say, John Henry, you about ready for me?
Sure thing, fun loving. Right this way.
This my man. Okay, let's get it on. I got a lot of business to take care of today. All up and down these mean streets. Not that it worries me none, though. Because I ain't giving up nothing. I wouldn't give a cripple crab a crutch if I owned a lumber yard.
Fun loving, don't be so mean.
Hey, speak me. Huh? Your post. Man, your post.
Hey, lady, you can't come in here. No ladies allowed.
The kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power.
Don't let that sister answer me.
Choose, then. Am I to come to you with a rod in my hand or in a sweet and gentle spirit?
Shoot your best shot, lady.
Oh, be proud of yourselves, for his heart, though he is absent in body, he is present in spirit. And his judgment upon the sinner is already given. Yes, Jesus, yes.
Hallelujah.
Given as if he were indeed present.
Hold on there, sweet meat.
Come on, sweet meat. Hold on, man.
Hold on.
Sorry, lady. We love the good Lord, too, but you're going to have to work your show from the outside. I ain't never let a lady pass me. Not one, Lord. And there ain't no sense in a boy breaking a good record like that. No, Lord.
Hey, preach, sweet meat. Preach, baby.
The man who sins is to be consigned to Satan for the destruction of his body, so that his spirit may be saved on the day of the good Lord.
Go ahead.
In the name of the Lord, Jesus Jehovah.
Come on, sister, save us.
Amen.
Stop right there, sir. Stop dead in your tracks. Don't you take another step further. The treatment. Oh, John Henry.
Come on, get with it, baby. Clean it up. Come on, now.
Boy, them little old ladies sure tickled me. They ought to be out in the suburbs spreading the word. It's Whitey who needs to be reminded that the Bible says you got to reap what you sow.
Yeah. Hey, Preston.
And in his judgment upon the sinner is already given.
You better watch it, sweet meat. I heard that God was a black woman.
And you know what that means. We all gonna have to pay some mighty heavy dues. With God a black woman, we'd be in trouble.
Why don't you cats wise up? Anybody can talk about what's wrong with black women. I want to hear somebody talk about what's right with them.
Black women are evil.
Now just a little bit on the top here.
Oh, not too much off the top. She could be looking like a man.
Oh, no, I don't want to look like no man, Stormy.
Y'all so backward. I mean, really, do I look like a man?
Why don't you touch it up a little bit more right over there?
Who is doing this, chick? Huh? Move.
Ruby.
Hold it. I think we almost got it. I think that's it. Okay. Look. Give me a drink.
Is this me?
You do look sort of different.
Hey, I see you still in the CP time, sport.
Oh, what you talking about, man? I'm right on time. Shoot.
Hey.
So what you been up to, huh?
Well, I'm just there, you know, by being careful.
I did.
Just skipping on by. Man, it's been a long time since I've been up here. Remember I used to have that pigeon coop right over there?
Yeah.
Oh, the hours I used to spend up here.
You wouldn't even allow me up here, dude.
Man, it sure seems like a long time ago. It's funny how time just dances by. Hey, remember that chick across the street, huh? That big-legged chick that you brought up here that time, what was her name?
What you talking about?
Oh, come on now, man. Now, you remember. Now, what was her name? Remember, you got upset because during the whole Johnson, she couldn't stop popping the gum.
You remember?
What's her name, huh?
Oh, man.
Gloria.
That's her name. Gloria.
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 Gloria. Gloria. Cook.
Yeah, yeah, so you remember, man.
Yeah. Man. I thought you wanted to talk to me about something anyway.
Yeah, well, it's about that.
Is that all you want to talk about?
Hey, Wade. Now, I talked to him a long time last night. He's really getting upset.
Oh, man, that dude is always upset about something.
You could listen to what I have to say.
Right, go ahead.
Now, you know how the old man likes to keep his business to himself. Well, neighbors are talking, and it's getting to him.
Yeah, well, that's what this whole thing is about, big brother.
Hey, Dad's really a nice guy when you get to know him. You want to know what's really happening with him? He's lonely. Now, I didn't understand that before, but when you move out on your own, you begin to see things.
Yeah, I hear you humming, but I ain't coming.
Look, get in. All I'm asking you to do is to just meet the old man halfway, that's all.
Man, now, Dad is living in the 1930s. And you asking me to meet him halfway? Ain't this some incredible stuff?
Now, you know, instead of giving out advice like that, you ought to be getting your own house in order.
What do you mean by that?
I didn't say what I had to say, man. People who live in glass houses just ought to be cool, that's all.
If you got something to say, why don't you just come out and say it?
All right, I will. Tell me, man, you got anything against sisters?
Oh, wow. I haven't got anything against sisters. Why?
How come I ain't never seen you uptown with no chicks there? Yeah, so?
So? So there's a whole lot of boss sisters out there, man. Can't you find one?
Hey, Gideon, look, I don't know what you're talking about.
You wanna know what I think? I think you're afraid of sisters because you can't deal with them. Yeah, that's right. You the kind of dude who winds up marrying white. You probably got some gray chick on the side right now. What you think about that?
I just think you're one crazy nigga. That's what I think. You run into some dynamite smoke or something? Because if you did, give me some so I can be crazy like you.
Well, do you?
Do I what?
Do you have a white girlfriend?
Hey, look, man, I don't know what you're talking about.
Booker, why don't you stop playing games, man? Now, you were seen going down to Terry's with a blonde. You were seen at the Boondocks with a blonde.
So I go out with a white girl every now and then. What are you getting so excited about? It's not your business. It's highly personal. I happen to dig a certain quality in a chicken. I haven't met a sister that I could groove with, that's all.
Oh, hey. Hey, Booker. Sisters are some very beautiful people, man. We can't afford to be getting into no negative things with them. How can we build a nation of strong families without them?
Mm-hmm. Tell me anything. Spit on my back. Tell me it's raining. Next thing I know, you be telling me you came up here just to build a strong family.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, otherwise I'd have moved out like you did.
Hey, man, who I sleep with is my own personal business.
Oh, no, man, no. Who you sleep with, the first face you see in the morning is very significant, man. That's where you get your energy from. It's your mirror, Booker. That is your mirror. Can you dig it? Now, man, you ought to be getting your black thing together instead of going around sleeping with the enemy, huh?
No, people are people. That white chick ain't nobody's enemy. She's an individual, and a beautiful one at that. But that's not the point. The thing is, it's me. Me. And if you don't understand that, then shame on your black hide.
Oh, man, you got to get out of that me thing. Why don't you wake up? It ain't about yourself, man.
And what are you getting so excited about a girl that you don't even know?
So I don't want to see my brother run around being a hypocrite. Now, I mean, if you're into a white thing, then stop talking black. You confusing people, Booker. Sneaking around. Be a man.
All later for you. Because I ain't got time to be standing around listening to a whole bunch of nonsense.
Well, how about it, Super Spade? You gonna take that white girl to the wedding? I'm sure Mom and Daddy will be highly impressed, huh?
All right, Einstein, all right. Now, I know what you need. I haven't given you a dusting off in a long time.
Look, I don't want to get into no physical thing with you, man. I'm just asking you to be a man, a black man. That's all. Stop trifling. That's
no,
all.
No, man, I know exactly what you need. Come on, get up, chump. I'm gonna rock your sky. Hey, man, put down that spear, huh?
So rock all the skies you want. I just want my cut, that's all.
Turkey. Talking about being a man, huh? Where's your heart?
My head, where it's supposed to be.
All right, chump. Hen house. You put down that spear, you afraid of a fair one?
What's the matter, can't you do anything besides talk, huh? Hypocrite. What's the matter, John Wayne?
You put down that spear and I'll teach you a lesson.
I'm already teaching you one, man. It ain't about a whole lot of talk. It's about action. Can you dig it? Action!
All later for you. I ain't got time to be bothered.
What's the matter, man? Where's your heart at?
You put down that spear and I'll show you.
A talk's cheap, chum.
Yeah? You gonna put down that spear?
Can a buffalo skate?
Later for you.
You do look different.
Sort of like, sort of African.
Yeah, Gladys, that's exactly what you look like. You look like one of them African queens.
Oh, an African queen.
Ruby, go upstairs and see if Gideon's up on the roof for me, please.
We don't have much time.
And he can be our consultant. Okay, now let me see if I can get these on you. Now, if you're going to be an African queen, you've got to carry yourself like one.
Okay.
Now walk. Hold your chin up, Gladys. Don't. Stop your shoulders. That's it. Now walk proud. Proud and beautiful.
Oh.
Ah, yeah. That's it. Okay, let's go. Oh, wait a minute. I got just one last thing to do.
Free as the breeze, and I do as I please. Besides, don't take nothing but a little money. Here you go, baby.
Fun loving, you're a scholar and a gentleman.
Thank you. Say, sweet meat.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now, I don't mean to be dipping into y'all's business, but I've been listening to you dudes talk about women, and I want to run down a little something to you. Now, all you need to get a woman is a strong rap. Hey, what I say. Every woman in the streets wants a piece of me. They call me Sweet Peter Jeter, the broom beater. The baby maker and the cradle shaker. The deer slayer, the bug binder, and the women's finder. I am known from the Gold Coast to the rocky shores of Maine. Fun loving is my name. And love is my game.
Said love is my game.
I'm the bed tucker, the milkshaker, the record breaker, and the population maker. The humdinger, the gunslinger, and the baby bringer. I am fun-loving the hard hitter and the poly noose getter. The judge, the sludge, the women's pet, the men's fret, and the family's pinup boy.
Fun-loving the trickster. I said fun-loving the berry picker, the city slicker, and the candy licker.
I ain't giving up nothing but bubble gum and hard time, and I'm fresh out of bubble gum. I'm the man who walked the water and tied the whale's tail in a knot. I taught the fish how to swim, yeah. Crossed the burning sand, and shook the devil's hand. I rolled around the world on a snail carrying a sack that said, air mail. I walked 49 miles of barbed wire, and I used a cobra snake for a necktie. Yes, I'm him, the dimp.
The women champ?
Women fight for my delight. I am a bad dude. Johnny Ripsaw, the devil's son-in-law. I gave a highway patrolman a speeding ticket and sold a blind man a flashlight. I am the only man in the world that knows why white milk make yellow butter. I even know where the lights go when you cut the switch off. Now, I might not be the baddest man in the world, but I'm in the top two, and my father is getting old.
Father is getting old. You really selfish.
This is the king.
The door, sweet meat.
Oh, Lordy. Hey, you can't come in here. No women allowed.
This is a new day. That's right, a new day.
Mrs. Brooks?
Mrs. Brooks?
Mrs. Brooks!
Mrs. Brooks?
Mrs. Brooks!
In the name of peace, self-determination, and liberation, I demand that you sign my list of demands.
List?
List of demands?
Of demands!
List of demands! And they are non-negotiable.
Just shut up!
Selfish or anything, but why'd you choose a time like this to stand up to Dad?
Oh, baby, I don't know. It's more like the time chose me.
Right. Okay, Troop. Now get ready for phase two.
How'd it go, son?
Just like clockwork, Mama. A sign the boys came through like thoroughbreds.
Yeah, perfect execution. Man, that was something else.
Hey, what's the matter with you, sis?
A family squabble in the middle of your wedding. Oh, Gideon, what's gonna happen? It's like you're trying to organize a war.
Gail, go downstairs and tell your father to sign that list. And tell him it's his last chance.
Oh, wow.
Come on now. It's gonna be all right, sis.
I just hope everybody remembers there's supposed to be a wedding tomorrow, that's all.
Gail's so worried about a wedding, I feel like calling off the whole thing.
Mama.
I remember my wedding, and I know exactly how she feels.
Yeah, well, just relax, huh? Just relax, Mama. Everything is gonna work out fine, hear? Just fine. Now, let me call on Stormy Monday, see how she's doing. H1? H1, this is H5. Do you read me?
Dad, blast it. I'm gonna be late. Booker T, which one of these do you like best?
Let's see.
Woman leaving me at a time like this. She could have at least put out my clothes before she left. I'm telling you, son, there's a whole lot of inconsideration in this world.
I think I like this one.
Gail, what did your mother say?
She's not coming back until you sign the list.
What? Has she lost her mind? What's wrong with that woman anyway?
Hey, Dad, you haven't even read Mama's demands yet.
Let me get ready. I'm already late.
But, Dad, you can at least read it.
Never!
What is going on up there?
Everything. Charts, binoculars, walkie-talkies. I just hope everybody remembers there's a wedding tomorrow.
What's going on out there, huh?
Excited. One of Mama's friends is just picketing the front door, that's all.
Oh, that's sweet meat.
What? Oh, hold on.
What are they doing to me?
been dead. John Henry?
John Henry! Man, you got to do something. They've taken over our barbershop.
What?
Taken over the barbershop?
Who?
High Sand and a bunch of other kids with a whole lot of hair on their heads.
Well, come on, sweet meat. There's a couple of baseball bats in the closet. We're gonna clear up that barbershop.
Dad, wait. Wait a minute now. Use your head, please. Now, can you imagine the headlines? Barber arrested, wielding a baseball bat. You'd be the laughing stock of the whole town.
The boy is right, John Henry.
We gotta come up with a counter plan. We gotta start negotiating.
Right, right.
I absolutely refuse to make any bargains under pressure.
Oh, John Henry. Dad, it's only a front. We'll tell Mama. We're willing to discuss her demands, but only on the condition that she call off the picketing and open up the barbershop.
I see. And while we're talking, business continues as usual.
But that's not fair!
Gail, you want your wedding to come off tomorrow, don't you? Read the demands to Dad while I go upstairs.
Hey, son, if you can't talk some sense into Gideon, see if you can't pull your mother off to the side. Maybe we can split them. Yes.
Okay, Daddy. I, John Henry Brooks, Jr., do hereby agree that things must change, and that henceforth a new relationship will now exist between me and my wife, Gladys Ann Brooks. Therefore, I agree to the following. I will no longer slurp my coffee. I will remember to put the top on the toothpaste. I will not pass gas in the bedroom. I will no longer require my wife to keep an appointment book.
What?
I will no longer require my wife to save the trays from TV dinners.
Trays from?
From now on, I will give my wife a weekly allowance. I will call her Gladys and not Mrs. Brooks. I will allow her to work as a manicurist in my barbershop.
Over my dead body.
I will no enough.
Longer lose I said that's enough. I absolutely refuse to listen to any more.
Now, John Henry.
But, Daddy, I'm not even half through.
Gail, I said that's enough. What's the phone doing off the hook?
Oh, my God, Marvin! Oh, no. He hung up. I give up. I'm going to my room.
Good.
Yeah! All right.
Gideon, will you please report on what's happened so we can get phase three started?
Okay. Phase one, took over the barbershop.
Right?
Check. Yeah.
Phase two, set up pickets all around the building.
Check.
Now, phase three is where you come in starting Monday.
Gotcha.
Hey!
We ready.
And if he still doesn't sign, then we go into phase four and phase five.
Yeah, well, sometimes I wish we didn't have to do it like this, Mama.
Me too. But you know, they say a hard head makes a soft behind. The way your father's carrying on, you think I was asking him to jump off the London Bridge. All I want him to do is to relax and let me love him.
Good morning, everybody. Sure is a pretty day, ain't it?
Look who's sliding in.
Well, how is everybody?
Look, man, if it ain't about Dad signing that list of demands, we don't want to hear it.
Mama, Dad's been going through a lot of changes lately. Been doing a lot of deep thinking, and he's ready to start discussing your demands.
Yeah, I'll bet.
Hey, man, I'm trying to talk to Mama. See, Mama, it's like this. After all, we can't forget about Gail downstairs.
with a wedding on her mind?
Well, what's wrong with Gail? Is she all right?
Mama, now don't you listen to this dude. Now, man, is Dad ready to sign that list?
Hey, well, see, the thing is...
Is he ready to sign the list or not, man?
Well, you see, it's like this,
Mama. Huh? Man, until Dad is ready to sign that list of demands, we got nothing to discuss. Come on, Mama, we got our staff meeting to get to.
Relax, sweet meat. Relax.
You keep saying that, but I'm wondering about our customers.
Relax, sweet meat, and cool it. Booker T's negotiating my interest. That's probably him now.
Hey, what's going on? Is Gail all right?
Of course she's all right. We're having a little misunderstanding, that's all.
Oh, Marvin, am I ever glad to see you. Oh, I wanted to call you back. You're not mad, are you?
I'm not mad, babe. I was just worried. What's going on anyway? Why are the pickets?
I can't understand you, Booker T. Instead of you trying to convince me to give in to your father, you should be trying to encourage me to stand up to him.
But, Mama, the two of you been together all these years.
Only because I kept my mouth shut all these years.
Oh, Mama, I know the old man could be a little rough at times, but I thought you loved him.
I do. I love your father. In fact, we all love your father, but nobody can live with him.
And all the time I thought that the two of you were really a beautiful couple.
You got a lot to learn about women, son. Never make a woman do anything to make her lose respect for herself.
Look, man, I think you better go on back downstairs.
Yeah, the Pickerton takeover is just light action.
Because if Dad don't come through, we're going to sock it to his case.
Right, all right. Really?
Now, you tell him he got 5 minutes to sign that list or we coming out smoking.
Hey, man, I'm trying to talk to Mama.
Why don't you lighten up? Now, you ain't talking to a white girl.
Man, you better watch yourself or I'll...
What?
Huh? All right, just keep on, man. Just keep on pushing me, man.
Then what?
Just keep right on.
For what? I'm pushing you. Keep on.
Come on, I'm pushing you.
Get on down here.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Hey, man, hey, calm down.
Oh, Marvin, I'm so glad you're here.
Gideon, what has come over you? Oh, look, man, it was bad enough when you were up here by yourself, but now you got your mother involved, too. No good.
That's what I've been trying to tell him,
now,
Marvin.
Wait, now you are no better, Sharif, supporting your father trying to jive your mother.
Hey, now, wait a minute, man.
Don't deny it, Sharif. Gail heard you and Mr. Brooks. You're just stalling for time.
You see here, man. You see, I told you you was wrong,
wait,
dude.
Wait, hey, I say you're both wrong. Fighting in the streets. Telling lies. Always quoting Chairman Mao. Right, but you should remember what Malcolm said. You do not solve a family squabble in public. Gideon, look, man, you can use those calculating tactics against outsiders. With your family, man, you use another value system. One based on love. And respect. Sharif, I expected more from you. You're supposed to be a new black man, and you're coming up shaky.
But I was doing it for the good of the family, for father. For...
I don't see how you can preach black liberation and still refuse to support your own mother in her struggle for self-respect. Now, come on, man. We gotta stop this bickering. The only valid ism is we-ism. We cannot allow differences to separate the family. Sharif, man, your mother is fighting for her dignity. You should support that. And Gideon, bro, you just got to find a way to deal with your father.
Right on, Marvin. Now, let's put our heads together and see if we can find a way to liberate Mr. Brooks.
Hi, Dad.
Booker, what took you so damn blessed long? How does it look?
Dad, you've been had.
Had?
Boy, what the devil are you talking about? You talk to him, sweet meat, he's crazy.
Hey, Dad, you better sign while you're still ahead.
Booker T, what's come over you?
Sit down, Dad. If the picketing and the takeover don't work, they're planning on picketing the bank where you keep your account.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Dad, Mama's got her communication thing together, too. She's printing up some leaflets, sort of, position papers, and having the kids pass them out in the community.
Position papers?
Right. And dig this, Dad. She's also setting up a press conference. She's already talked to the newspaper men, and now she's working on a contact with CBS.
CBS? Mm-hmm. Why, I'll crush her with my very hands.
Dad, just in case there's any rough stuff, Mama's got a group of women karate experts waiting. Stormy Monday's the commanding officer.
Man, you better get you a lawyer.
Mama's already talked to three lawyers, and the one lawyer on your side told Mama that the least she can get in a settlement is the apartment and all the money.
All the money?
Right. Why, she's even considering asking for a congressional investigation.
Son, what are we going to do?
What do you mean, we, baby?
Booker T, where are you going?
I'm going upstairs and talk to a lady.
A lady?
Right. She's got a mind like a razor and a heart as big as a watermelon.
What? What are you talking about?
Your wife.
No. The bad guys are winning.
Participate in and witness the sacred ceremony of marriage, which has been since the time of the firstborn a means of establishing a house, that is to say, to start a home and a family, for it is by this that the community endures. Brother Marvin, you are and shall be the head of the house. You must lead, but not be a burden. Be strong and loving, considerate and creative, respectful, faithful and understanding. Sister Gail, you are blessed to have a man who will love you, fulfill your needs and protect you. Be humble and loving, appreciative and resourceful, so that you can provide continuous inspiration for your husband, cultural education for your children, and participate in the social development of our nation. Marvin and Gail, you must be as one in your thoughts, beliefs, and action. And though you, Marvin, are to lead, and you, Gail, are to follow, there is no superior or inferior. We promise nothing unreal, but where there's love, faith, work, and endurance, there's a house of happiness. Now you must promise each other to love, have faith, work, and endure, for it is this commitment to each other that is the basis for the commitment to the community. Brother Marvin, Wahidi.
Nina Kwaidi.
Sister Gail, Wahidi.
Nina Kwaidi.
For as long as you honor this commitment, so shall your house be one of happiness. For you there shall be no longing, for you shall be fulfillment to each other. For you there shall be no harm, for you shall be a shield to each other. For you there shall be no searching, for you shall be an end to each other. As Marvin and Gail are aware of their responsibilities to each other, to their children, and to the community, and sincerely want to establish their house, so let us all accept it. The families of the bride and groom extend their blessing to the sacred ceremony by partaking of this cup. And as we have all accepted it, so let it be done for now and all time, for as long as the sun shines and the water flows.
was a lovely ceremony.
I still can't believe you got Mr. Brooks to sign that list of demands. You ought to be mighty proud of yourself, girl. Mighty proud.
Thank you, Ruby.
You reckon something like this would help with my Wilbur?
Oh,
howdy, Mrs. Brooks.
Oh, hi, Preston.
Oh, how you doing? Oh, Preston, I want to meet my friend Ruby.
How you doing, ma'am?
I'm doing just fine. Just fine. We want some punch? Is that enough?
It's just fine. Something wrong, Mrs. Brooks?
Oh, I was just looking for John Henry.
Hold that, lady.
Beautiful.
Howdy, Mrs. Brooks. You eating again, Preston?
You early, but you late.
Sweetmeat, have you seen John Henry?
Not since we was singing and carrying on.
Oh, Sweetmeat, I want you to meet my friend Ruby. Ruby, this is Sweetmeat.
Mighty pleased to meet you, ma'am.
Your face looks awful familiar to me. I seen you somewhere else before.
You ain't seen me, woman.
Oh, there's Gideon.
Propose a toast to the newlywed king and queen.
Amen. Stormy Monday said she was gonna make that toast.
But where is she? Hey, y'all see Stormy Monday?
Here I am. Here I am.
Stormy. Let me help you.
Thank you. Now I want you all to know I was up half the night getting this number together. Right. To the bride and groom. May your tribe increase. May your feet always point toward Mecca. And may happiness hound you like a tax collector. And whether you love wisely or foolishly, may you always love. Okay, let's start dancing before I do something stupid. I cry.
Come on.
Be anything you want to be, as long as you're the best at it.
All right.
Dad, you're out of sight.
Dig deep.
Look at John Henry.
Wonders will never cease.
He got enough stuff around his neck to open up a 5 and 10 cent store.
Give me 5 on the black hand side. Glad as I am.
Nice.
Glad as I am.
Hold that pose. Fine as the wine you drink when you die. Time for the big one. Okay. Everybody say cheese.
Life is so bad.
Looking black and being black is as different as fire and rain. Loving it and living it is the way we do.